I started out training just to be stronger because I used to be a soccer player. And a friend of me take me to his place and we start training and he's my only trainer ever since. I start training when I was 15 with a guy called Kenneth. The Pacific rules of Fighter must obey in my gym is they have to have respect for one another. They have to be loyal. And of course, you know, we live by the rule. If you don't want it to do it to you, don't do it to anybody else. A fighter must have some qualities like, of course, being loyal, want to learn, be able to want to work. And then if I see something special in him, you know, then we can go further. Otherwise, you'll be just one of the other guys who just train there because I've got a lot of members in my gym, of course. And if you want to be at a special group, then you have to be outstand the other fighters, of course. Oh, no. Then you turn the last one around.
Okay.
Because you want to go for the liver.
Yeah, I know.
Yes.
That's
a
better combination.
Yes. Oh, you. Boom. And then here. So, as a southpaw, you punch. Bam. Boom. Bam. Boom.
Oh, okay.
Huh?
Okay, that's better.
No problem. Southpaw too. You see? One, boom. That's too much. One kick. No, one in the kick. One kick. One kick. Boom. Foot back. Take your foot. No. Kick. Take your foot back. Lift it up. Take it back here. And then this one. Huh? Now step in. One, two.
This
one. One. Step in. Step forward. One. The other one, two, boom. This is, you understand? You know, so in the end of the day, you know, you set the higher level for yourself, and I think that's what a champion does. You know, taking it every day a little bit higher for himself. And then at the end of his career, he has to look back and be proud of what he did all of his entire career. And I said, yes, I lived and trained like a champion. Well, even guys like Badr Hari or Gerd Masaki, Melvin Manuf, Edo Groenart, Artur Kishenko, they come in the gym every day and learn something, you know? There is always a side we didn't cover. There's always something we didn't know. That's why we also sometimes lose a fight. No, that's normal in life. You can't have all the answers, but we try to cover all the base. And if it sometimes you don't learn anything specifically about boxing or kickboxing, but you can maybe learn something about mentality, or you can learn something about the mind games, or you can learn something about body language. You know, so there's much, much to learn. Because you go like this. And you make yourself punch same time. Boom, I run myself knockout. You know? Now, I punch in here, boom.
Straight.
This. Oh. Take it back. Take the foot further back. Because here comes. One. Low kick. Boom. Take the foot further back. One more time. Boom, low kick.
Yes.
Put that. You see?
Yes.
Now you're here. Boom. And you're here.
Yeah, I understand.
Okay. Well, a fighter can succeed with only one weapon because all fighters are different. You know, and everybody got the good things and the bad things. And if you've got a good thing like a good left high kick, then it's my job to make you fight, that you always be able to put your left kick free. You understand? So you fight, bam, 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 you know, so I give combinations so that you can land that left kick. or somebody ever got a good left hook, other guys got a right strong arm. So you have to get yourself in a position that you can throw this weapon. Otherwise, you know, it's useless. But some people got no weapons at all, but you know, they covered everything, a 6 or a 7, you know, and they can manage. And some people got 1 or 2 things they can do better than the other, than average. Yeah, they got a good right hand or a good low kick. So you can add the combinations to them, so they can always throw the low kick and from each angle. Relax, turn your hands in, punch from here. In. And every time you punch, squeeze your hand. No, not here, but here.
Shinjian.
Try. You feel the difference? Don't tell anybody. Well, to become a good fighter, well, some people can train 24 hours a day and never will become a good fighter, but most of our good fighters train 2 times a day, 5 times a week, and starts in the morning with weights, then running, then kickboxing, in the evening kickboxing for another 2 hours, and on a Saturday we do a back workout or some running. Step outside the leg and punch with the left. Boom. Yeah, so from here, back, outside, punch left. Yes, because when I kick to the body, we learn this one, now the hook is coming. Yes, okay. So now we do the same, he's coming with the hook. Sleeping. Well, today we had a workshop here in Slovenia. And the thing I wanted to learn them, or teach them, is, you know, just not to rush your combinations, but, you know, in your combinations take time so another, and so your opponent can punch back, and that you don't get hit or don't get surprised by the attack of your opponent by stepping back and then attack him again. That's one thing. The other thing is keep your distance, you know? And sometimes your distance can be really close for one combination, but for another combination you must be far away and fight from there. And the other thing what I wanted to learn in seminars is try to fight from a different angle. You know, by stepping to the side and attack from there, or, you know, or just kick and step to the side so you don't get hit if somebody throws a punch. That's what I tried to learn today. You know, I don't know if it came across, because, you know, sometimes they say, I understand, but they don't. And sometimes they look at me, but they do understand, because I see it by the way they move. But they understand, but they still can't feel it. You know, it's. I don't say this is the best or the perfect technique. I just want to show them something that I think nobody thinks about in fighting. And if they are training, and I hope one day it comes together, you know, it gives them a click. They go, oh, that's what he meant, and that they can move on to the next level in their game. That's what I wanted to learn them today. Yes, just switch, bam, kick in. Just switch from the hook. You just switch your legs to the side and then kick. Yes, go on. My message to all people who wanted to do martial arts, kickboxing, MMA or whatever, you know, just have fun. It's sports. That's what sports are made of. Sports are fun to do, you know. Don't be so competitive, it's just sports. Just enjoy learning and be the best kickboxer you can be. It doesn't mean you have to be the next K1 or Glory champion. It doesn't mean you have to be the next UFC champion. But maybe if your best fighter is to fight one time in your life on a challenger championship of WFC, if that's your best, then go for that. And if if it's not in you, but you are the best thing, is just to train 3, 4, 5, 2 times a week, but you train the hard you can be in a good shape, so you'll be able when you get older and you got kids of your own to play with your kids and not be some old guy who's sitting there after 5 minutes but run for 1 hour after your kids. You know, then you're happy. It works for you. You know, when you do sport, you forget all of the trouble in the world. You forget all of your own trouble just for 1 hour or 2 hours or how long the workout is done. And I think that's the best you can do. Just enjoy the sport. Don't think about anything else, just sports.